the church instead of praying. But yet people wasn't worried about anybody coming in the church. And they weren't worried about anybody going out the church. All they were worried about was themselves. But yet, they want to stay positive. But Jesus walked on in the church. And the Bible said he threw everybody out the church. Because my Father's house is always positive. Threw them out the church. Nobody had even exchanged hands. They tried everything. But lo and behold, Jesus still is in control.
Yes. That's right.
Talk about my Father's house. Shell is written in the Old Testament. Shall be called the house of prayer. But you turn it into a different thing. Bible said, if you go back into John chapter 2, yes, Jesus said, take these things. Make not my Father's house and house of merchandise. For it, and then the disciples remembered what was written in the Bible, that the zeal of thine house had eaten. Talk about Jesus. When he cast everything out, he ended up. Nothing left the temple but the people. What am I trying to tell you? In order for the church to stay positive, you got to throw out all the negative things. But what they want to know, what sign do you have to show me in order to do these things? Now remember, these people aren't in the church anymore. They're now out of the church. What signs? Or who are you to come to my house and tell me what I can and cannot do? Who are you to tell me that I've been doing wrong all these years? And yet, I don't have to hear a word that you got to say. But yet, you're outside the church. You're not in the church no more. So I tell you what Jesus did. Jesus said, out of 3 days, I will destroy this temple. And in 3 days, I'll build it back up again. All right. But the people didn't think about anything else but the church.
Really?
And all they could say was 40 and 6 years this temple stood. How are you going to destroy it in 3 days? Didn't know that he wasn't talking about the church anymore.
Yeah.
He's now talking about his own body. In 3 days, I'm going to destroy this body. But in 3 days, I'm going to raise it back up again. So that somebody else might live. But then, ask you 3 questions. First, I told you you had to recognize who Jesus is. Right. Then I told you, you got to know what Jesus can do. And the third question I said, where are you going to go? That's always positive. And that is the church. But then you got to recognize there's a fourth thing. That Jesus don't need no help. Even in a negative world. He don't need no help. He don't need help from Salvation Army. When it comes to helping people in need, he don't need no help from people in the United States rushing to go see how other people are doing. Jesus don't need no help.
Well,
why? Because he always got everything in his hands.
Yes,
so why, talk about the members now, why when you were in trouble, do you always run to somebody else? And when all else fails, then you want to run to Jesus. they were going to help him. They decided, well, we got to kill him. We got to get rid of him. He's teaching that there are people that are following. He's preaching that there are people that are listening. So we got to get rid of him. But Jesus that night left Jerusalem. And on his way back, he saw that same fig tree dried up from the roots. And all the disciples remember what Jesus said. Peter said unto Jesus, Lord, behold the fig tree that you cursed.
Yeah.
Jesus said, and if you want to know how to stay positive in the negative world, you've got to have faith in God.
Yeah.
I came to tell you that you've got to have faith in God. No matter what you might be going through, have faith that he will deliver you. Have faith that he can supply all your needs. Have faith that he's able to do everything but fail. Even when you're hungry, he could heal, he could give you food in a time when there's no hunger, there's no food. Remember that he's sheltered in the time of a storm. Remember that he healed the sick and he raised up the dead. Remember that he opened blind eyes and caused a lame man to walk. I came to tell you to stay positive even in a negative world. I came to tell you to remind you that Jesus is coming back, whether you want him to or not. I